Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom Shop here. Okay, some of you have asked me in the past on how to locate some of the more smaller parts inside a Tokyo Marie 1911 or MEU. I've done the high capper, and I also did a strip down of the MEU, or at least an equivalent, a little while back, well, quite a while back now, but that video doesn't show it clearly enough, or it seems to not show you clearly enough, what actually goes on in this area. So I thought I'd clear that up. Now then, all it is regards the spring location. You must make sure that that spring, I don't know if you can see it, but that spring, you've got a piece that goes up at one end and a flat end the other end, this end. Now that flat end is located behind this little tiny nub piece here, for want of a better word. It's got to be located behind that. So what you do is, very very trickily, but you do it, is, hopefully you'll be able to see this, is you just drop that in, he says. As I say, it's very very difficult to do, but it does go in there. There we go. Sorry if you didn't see that, but it's located behind the back of that. Then all you do is you get the brass tube, whatever you want to call it, sear post, that goes down through the centre of it. Now, with regards to this, there are, I don't know if you can see, but there's a straight shaft on one side of this washer, and there's a stepped shaft the other side. Now the straight shaft is the section that goes down inside that spring. So the stepped side stays on the up, is facing upwards. Alright, so it's only the straight shaft that goes downwards. So again, you grab the brass piece, put it in, like so. Then you get your knocker actuator, or whatever you want to call it, valve actuator. This is the part that upward piece on the spring sits in. It sits on that little gap there. I don't know if you can see it, but there's like a little gap. There you go. That gap is what the upward part of the spring sits in. And then this pin here that's on the end of it, that sits into that little slider piece there, that little groove that's in there. All right. Very, very tricky to get this because, well, it is just a pain, so bear with me. But you've got to drop that over the spring, which that is. Then you bend it upwards, dropping that into position. And then you hold that all in position, like so. All right. Then all you do, I don't know if you can see that, but there we go. That's held down now. That's in position. That's not going to go anywhere. Well, at least not whilst my finger's in the way. Then you get your sear, which is this one here, and you drop that down over the top of that brass shaft, or sear shaft, whatever you want to call it. That then holds that in position. Then you get the back right hand rear half, whatever you want to call it, the section that is screwed into position that holds it all in place. You then just drop that, making sure that you locate the screw in the right place, over the top of the lot of it. There we go. Alright, so that's over the top. Now let's get my favourite screwdriver and and locate the screw. Now then, little tip, this screw, especially fine screws, this one is quite fine, is you do not want to cross thread. So what I do is I back up a little bit first. I turn it as if you're going to undo it, and then you hear a click. Did you just hear that then? If I do it again. There we go, there's a click. That click, there we go. That click that you just heard means that it's located in the threads. So now you can start to tighten it up. And as you can see, it will go in as it should do. Because otherwise, if you try and screw it in straight away, if you haven't got the thread exactly located in the right spot, you'll cross-thread the screws. And these screws are very hard to come by. So instead of stripping the head, or stripping the thread, I should say, then it pays to make sure that you put it in the correct way. Right, let's tighten that up. Another thing, another little tip, never over tighten. So when you've got it down and it's fully tightened, just back off a little bit. So there's just a little bit of give there. What I would say is if you're not aiming to take this apart at any time, I would suggest that you thread lock these screws in. It's a lot better and it's a lot safer because the screw thread then won't give, it won't vibrate and won't fall out. I haven't done it this time because this is going to be stripped down again, but this was just to demonstrate what goes on. Now then, the other thing you've got to be careful about is, which I've just heard pop out on the other side, is this. That was actually located in there, but it's not located now, but never mind. What this is your actuator spring, which if, actually let's see if this will go upwards, it should do, he says, hopefully. There we go. There we go, it's up. See, that's sprung loaded. That's what your knocker valve, which is that in there, which you've just located, that's what that actuates. So when that is in that position, then the knocker valve is actually backwards. Is fired. It's actually disengaged. So when that is up, then your knocker valve inside there, that thing that the sear is holding in, that the spring is located in, that the upright bit of the spring is located in, when that is in that position, up, then that means that the gun has fired. So as soon as the slide comes back, all it does is it relocates that actuator downwards. It pushes it down, compressing that spring, which then pops your knocker valve, actuator pin, whatever you want to call it, forwards. Resets it back. So it pushes it backwards, which is where it is at the moment. So as soon as it's set back, then obviously the hammer is dropped and it's all ready to go off again. So when that is up, the knocker valve is forwards, i.e. is fired. As soon as the slide comes back, it pushes that down, which then reactivates the knocker valve, i.e. resets it. All right. Now then, this is the tricky part, because I've got to try and make sure. Just push that forward. There we go. If I just push the actuator forward, which I've just done, that then frees this up. It's able to go upwards. So it gives you a bit more room to put the spring in. Now the spring is tricky. How I do it is I put this end in first, hold that with my finger, I try and show you on camera, it's going to be pretty difficult, but I'll try. Push that in like so. As you can see, I've got the spring in like so. Then I just push it in with my other finger and locate it into the bottom section. Alright, so you just hold it in. So you're holding it all on your thumb or finger, whatever it is you're holding in the other end. So that's locked in position now. Then all you do is you get your disconnector. This is how I assemble it anyway. You don't have to do it this way. You can slot the disconnector in afterwards, but I usually do it this way. Get the disconnector, hold it on with your other finger onto the other side, like so. Slightly raise it, like so, so it's slightly pointing upwards, and then when you relocate it into the frame, like so, he says, if you can. Mind you, this is going to be pretty tricky to get in here. He says, there we go. Right, once you've slotted it in, then you push down. The actuator being upwards, if I take, actually I can't get this out because this is in place, I've done this rather hurriedly, but all you do is when the actuator is pushed outwards, i.e. that way, it's up at an angle, it will allow the trigger bow to go behind it. So if I show you again, the trigger bow is obviously located at the back edge of this. That rests on it like so. So you've got to make sure that that is up like that. If it's down like that, the trigger bow will go behind it, it will pinch it, and it won't go up. You'll have to, you know, strip it all down again. It just won't fit. So you've got to be careful, all right? So make sure that when you're assembling it and pushing it back into the outer frame, that your thumb or finger or whatever stays on that spring, holds it in position, and that your other finger stays on the actuator the other side. All right, make sure your act- the actuator, or disconnector I should say, is up at a slight angle, like so. Alright, and that's pretty much it. So there you go, that's how you assemble the inner gubbins or workings of the 1911 or MEU frame, or even the Detonics for that matter. It's very, very similar, they're all identical. In fact, it is. The lower frame on the Detonics is identical to the standard size 1911 or MEU. So there you go. Okay, so any problems? Whatever you do, though, whatever you do, do not lose that spring. If you lose that, you've had it. When you're actually stripping this out of the frame, I'll show you that at least. I'll do dispense with the disconnector for the moment. When you're taking it out of the frame, like so, this is how I usually do it. I put my thumb just onto the side of where the actuator is, the knocker valve actuator. Where that is, I put my thumb. So that way, I know that as that slides out, that spring is not going to go anywhere. Alright, so as you slide it out gently, keep your thumb, moving it down slightly, but keep your thumb on that spring, because otherwise it will literally ping off and you'll lose it into the undergrowth or into the blooming carpet. If you've got a shag pile carpet or whatever, then you've lost it for good. You can buy replacements, don't get me wrong, but it's just annoying and it's a pain in the backside. So I think they're only a couple of quid to buy as spares, but it's still a couple of quid that you could do without, plus the postage. So, alright, so make sure that you keep your thumb over it. Now then, you can let go sometimes if you keep it in place. Turn the whole lot over and make sure that it stays flat on your workstation or workbench, alright, if you're dealing with any of this workings on this side. So you can leave that where it is, alright, if you want to. Personally, I would take that spring out, because if you don't and it pings off, you've lost it. So I would take that spring out, take it out as you're working on it, alright. So I'm going to leave that upside down for now. So there you go. So that is the inner workings of your 1911, whatever, MEU. I haven't bothered putting in the hammer. I mean, I can do, I suppose, if you want me to. Alright, I will. I shall put the hammer in. Right, all you do, again, making sure that it stays flat to keep that actuator spring in on the other side. You undo, like so. Now then, you'll find that, right, that's it, that screw's undone. That should just pop straight off. It doesn't. The reason is there's a catch point. So keep the screwdriver in place and undo gently. There we go. The whole lot comes off. Now then, with the hammer, how you put this in place is put the hammer like so, so that it's disengaged. Then you get the hammer shaft, or I can't think of the name of it now. the hammer pin shaft that goes inside the hammer itself. You drop it in. There's like a thin, one end of it is thinner than the other end. It's hardly anything at all. It's a matter of like a thousandth of an inch, but it's just enough. You can feel it there. If you rub your nail up and down it, or your finger, you can feel it. The thinner end is what goes down into the hammer hole itself, inside the hammer. Alright, so you just drop that in. That way, as you can see, it's not going to fall through. Alright, so it should be captured in. Sometimes these hammers get worn. The high capper hammer, if you're thinking of using that on your 1911, whatever, you may find that the actual hole is slightly larger and that tube will drop right through. Don't worry about it, it will still work fine. So you've located it in there. Now all you do is you locate it into the frame, like so. There we go, that's located. Alright, so that is now in there. Again, come back to your screwed in section, the rear section. Now then, this is the tricky bit, because you've got to make sure that that lines up. There we go, it's lined up. So you know that that's not going to move. Yeah, it's all working okay. Always make sure that that lines up or seats itself correctly into this half of the frame. If it doesn't, and you go to screw it all together, you won't be able to fit it in the frame. And not only that, it'll bugger the hammer up. So be careful, all right? Okay, again, like I said earlier, you want to back up with the screw, so do it as if you're undoing it. There we go, there was a click then. I'll do it again just to... There we go, that's the click. Now you can start to screw the screw back into position, like so. Because otherwise you'll cross-thread it, and you don't want to do that. Because if you cross-thread these screws again, it's a pain in the backside, and they can be pretty tricky to get. There we go, that's just got nice and tight. So you back off a little bit, not a lot, just a little bit. And then that way, there you go, there's a little bit of movement there. But with threadlock, if you was going to do this, you'd put threadlock on the screw. When you threadlock it in, that isn't going to move anyway. Again, check the hammer that it's not too loose, that it's working, it's moving around. Yeah, that's okay, always check. And there you go, that is it. Then get your disconnector if you want to, as I said, place it on, but lift it slightly so it's in that position. And then that way, when you go to slide it into the frame, it won't catch on the trigger bow. Okay, hopefully that's helped you guys out as to the inner workings of an MEU or 1911. If you do get problems or you lose springs, whatever, then, as I say, you can buy them. Certain places do sell them, like Elite Shooting Centre and so forth. I think Red Wolf Airsoft also do spares. There's also... I can't remember whether it's King Arms or Nineball, I'm not sure, but there's two different companies that do actually do a whole set of replacement springs for these pistols. I bought two sets a little while back, and they're very, very good actually. I found that the knocker valve springs that go in there are slightly shorter. Don't know why, but they're slightly shorter, and they're a slightly higher tensile strength than the standard ones, but other than that, they're identical. So there you go. So that's it. That's your inner workings of the MEU or 1911. Hopefully that will help you guys out as to how to strip it down and do any maintenance on it. It's not that difficult. It's tricky, but it's not that difficult if you do it step by step. All right? Just take your time. If that little upright on the spring is, you know, really bugging you or whatever, put it to one side. Go and have a cup of tea, whatever, cup of coffee. Come back to it and start again. But you do need plenty of light. Don't try and do it in a darkened room, whatever. You know, if you haven't got good light in, then wait for the daytime, because if you lose that spring or any parts, any of the springs, you'll never find them. So, all right. So, and also in that respect, because those parts are steel, I would keep a magnet handy just to be on the safe side. So if it does go pinging off or you feel it hit you and land on the floor, whatever, you can't see it, get a magnet, go up and down over the carpet, wherever it is that you've lost it, and hopefully it will stick to the magnet. All right, just another little tip there, which does help if you've got a shag pile carpet. So there you go. Okay, so hopefully that's helped, and if you get any other problems, don't ask me to do another one of these videos. No. They is tricky to do, don't get me wrong, but, well, you guys have asked, so I thought I'd do it for you. Okay, that's LaZouche Custom Shop signing off in regards to a little bit of internal maintenance on your 1911 or MEU pistol. Bye for now.